In this video, we're going to look at some techniques I use to really turn on headlights in Photoshop with my car photography. There are a lot of different technologies used in headlights in cars ever since the first generation Audi R8 was released. A lot of manufacturers are incorporating a lot of different technologies with their headlights. It does give the freedom. You can really create really cool designs with headlights and taillights as well. But in this video, we're going to look at some of some techniques that I really like using. I think they work quite well. Some of the things I really kind of adapted and really created on my own, but others are from some other YouTube videos and some other techniques that that I found online. So I'll link those below, so please check those out to see where I actually started and really kind of adapted the process I use for the headlights. So first thing we're going to do, we're going to take a look at a couple photos and just we'll go through quickly and show you some of the things I do for my photos. So let's take a look. Okay, so the first thing with this photo, now of course we're going to turn on the headlights here, so let's take a look at what an LC500 headlight looks like with the lights on. So there's a couple things to take note of there. There is this sort of like V shape that's with the light. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna illuminate this, and we're gonna do that using the pen tool. We're gonna trace around the light itself, and we're gonna increase the exposure of the light. So the pen tool itself is a combination of clicking where to start and clicking points and altering those points. So with the turn here, we can simply stretch that to go with the curve, and we need to bring this back so the pen tool goes the other way. And we'll click here and around this corner here. We'll click here and we'll just stretch that. We'll take this anchor point, we'll bring it back a little bit and click here, and finally we'll close it off. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna right click in the middle of it, and we're gonna make selection, and we're gonna feather the radius of that selection just by 1 pixel. And what we're simply gonna do here, what I like to do is just use the brush tool in white, and what we're gonna do is we're just gonna paint in that selection. We'll increase the brush size here and brush that in. There we go, we'll deselect. And there it is, it's illuminated there. And that's pretty much all I would do for that particular portion of the light there. But with the bulbs, the LC500 has a combination of different bulbs inside the headlight itself. And we're gonna get to those, but first we're gonna trace these. Now, another method what you can use is the polygonal lasso tool. It is quicker, it's not as precise if you need to get around some corners. But with these being so small and the corners of them being quite sharp, we can simply click around and create a selection with the polygonal lasso tool. Doing the same thing, we're gonna feather the selection to 1, and we're simply gonna paint in over that selection with a white brush. Now with that, we'll just speed through the other two here. We're doing the exact same thing, making next selection, feathering the radius to 1 pixel and painting it in with a white brush. All right, great. So we have that there. And now the next thing to do, we'll just zoom out to take a quick look. And with the headlight, what we're going to do is we're going to enhance the actual bulbs itself and give it a nice light effect. And what that means is we got to use the a tool here to draw a particular circle. And what you got to do is hold the, I believe it's the shift key, to make it, make sure it is round. We're gonna fill it with black, and it is on a new layer, and we'll bring it to the top. And we're gonna render lens flare. We're gonna use the 105mm prime, and we'll bring it right into the middle here at 100% and push okay. Now with this selection, we're gonna use a blend mode, and we're going to use the blend mode of screen for this here. And what that does, it really just, of course, you need to do that to create the actual light effect itself. Now with this, we can move this any way we want. We can transform this particular selection, and we're gonna finalize it with a levels adjustment as well. Now zooming in, we can control T to free transform this particular selection. We can rotate it if we wanna do that. Any way you want, whatever you think looks best for the photo. We'll just move that back to right on top to where the bulb is here. All right, that looks pretty good. And what I like to do, now you can see with the, the aura, whatever you want to call it, you can see the lines of where that selection was made. We'll just control L to bring up levels, and we can adjust the levels to bring that down to make it pretty much disappear. So that just really takes a little bit of playing around with the selection until you get it exactly how you want it. Okay, now with this selection, we're simply going to take this, and instead of making a whole new one, we're going to duplicate that layer. Layer 2 copy, that's fine, and we're just going to move that to the next light. All right, great. Move this slightly forward here. There, that looks better. Okay, we can rotate that again if we want, and that's just to make it look a little different than the first one itself. And that's probably fine there. And then for the final light, we'll duplicate again. And there we go, that's the LC500. Now for the second photo, we're looking at a Mercedes AMG GTS. And what we're gonna do is just show you another example of creating the light effect here. So we'll make this selection on a new layer. We're gonna fill this with black. Filter, render, and lens flare. Again, at 100%, directly in the middle here. We'll click OK. And we're gonna change the blend mode to screen. Now with this, you can try some other blend modes. Lighten can look okay, but I do prefer screen for this. And what we're gonna do is deselect that. And we can make this bigger if we choose to do that. I'll just move this slightly. And there we go. Zoom in, take a look, and you can see the edge there. So we're gonna use levels, and we're just gonna adjust that so we can get rid of that there. All right, and that looks pretty good. And we will duplicate that layer. And we'll just bring this over, move this to the other light. And there we go. So that's it. So that's just a quick tutorial, show you how I kind of create a headlight effect in Photoshop for my photos.